up, Zach? I'm Titan.
Good to meet you, man. Good to see you.
Thanks for giving us a call, man.
We could really use your help to help us do some of these titanium first stages. I know you like to machine a lot of pretty complex parts, so just be careful with this because people's lives are on the line. They're breathing off and underwater, but we're relying on you to do it.
So when do you need the parts?
We really need these parts in about a week.
All right, in a week. That's gonna be really difficult. We're gonna try to make it happen for you, okay?
That sounds like a plan.
Cool.
First step is I gotta go back up there and set up the machine. First, I'm gonna get all my tools in my turret. I'm gonna go ahead and put my three jaw chuck on there with my hard jaws. So when we get the titanium, it's gonna be a bar. We're just gonna be able to feed it through. We're gonna machine a part, part it off, feed the bar through, machine another part, so on and so forth.
So I just finished programming this titanium part for Oceanic. It's got a lot of sealing surfaces here. If the finishes aren't like a mirror, we could have a sealing problem, and that could literally be life or death because water might be able to leak inside of it. First thing I've got is an OD tool that comes across the face of it. It's gonna take out as much material as it can in a couple of passes and actually do the whole outside contour. Afterwards, I'm gonna drill a part, and then I'm gonna have a couple of boring bars go and finish the inside. Rough it all out, and then take another finish tool on the outside and make everything beautiful. And then we have a part off tool that's gonna come and cut the part right off. We'll have done parts popping off.
Parts came out beautiful on op one. They look like jewelry. We're gonna set up operation two now. We're gonna get some turn tools, some drills, boring bars, groove tools. We can get everything out, get them all touched off and zeroed perfectly. It's tough metal, but we're gonna eat it for breakfast.
All right, so I just finished programming the last operation on the titanium regulator from Oceanic. There's a lot of ports and threads coming from all different angles. That's why I'm using the IMCO tools to get in there and get all the material out. They're awesome tools. They help me compete with the world. We have it setting into a fifth axis fixture from the guys down at fifth axis. Those guys make some beautiful equipment. I'm gonna simulate the tool. You can see it taking the cuts right here. The tool's gonna stay stationary and just move around, and the fifth axis is actually going to move. There's a lot of sealing surfaces here, and you can't even have the slightest bump. They're breathing off it, their life is dependent on it, and everything is gonna rely on the exact fact that we machined it perfect. Once all the dimensions spec out and we know that everything is dialed, the finishes are perfect, then we'll run the rest of the parts. Then I'm gonna jump in my truck tomorrow morning, run down to the Bay Area, show it to the team down at Oceanic. They're gonna be amazed.
Hey Titan, this is Mike Gunning, lead engineer.
Lead engineer, nice to meet you, Mike.
Nice to meet you.
Awesome, got some parts here for you.
Oh, cool.
Wow, those look amazing.
So what do you think about the 360 brass compared to the titanium? It's
the weight saving is just unbelievable.
We got about 45 component parts going in this assembly. It's gonna be doped to a maximum depth, about 220 feet. So it needs to work perfect.
It's all assembled. It looks awesome.
So what Sham's doing here is he's pressurizing the unit.
Would you see bubbles coming
up? You would see a massive amount of bubbles, yeah.
Zero bubbles.
No bubbles. We take it to the lab at this point and go ahead and dive it. What we're checking for is, you know, obviously the unit to fail at depth, so hopefully your parts hold up to the pressure.
Yes. If it fails, it's probably your machine, not my parts. I'm just saying. All systems go?
All systems go.
So now what we're gonna do is we'll start taking her down in depth. You watch this, and this is your mouthpiece. That's your exhalation and inhalation.
It makes the complete loop.
Yeah.
Inhalation, exhalation, that complete loop is how you're gauged.
It's just like having an actual diver swim down 200 feet, the same pressure, same everything.
Same everything.
Yeah, I never knew it was so high tech.
Now we'll go to 220 feet.
Ooh, we're going past 200.
Fingers crossed.
Yes.
We dove to about 240 feet.
Yep.
About a 0.98 work of breathing, which is phenomenal at that depth.
Phenomenal, I like that.
We're super happy with the product, how it came out today. Couldn't be happier with it. The next thing is to go out there and dive.
You gonna take that diver?
We're gonna take this product right here to go dive.
That exact one right there.
This one right here.
It's cold, it's foggy out, it's winter time, and I'm jumping in the water down here in Monterey, California. everything's working really good. The kelp forests are amazing. You tilt your head back and look up and you can just see all these fish up here and they're just cruising. Checking out some of these sea lions, they're all up here on the rocks above me and they're jumping off and dive bombing into the water, swimming around us and checking us out like we're the foreign creatures. Now that I'm down here, I'm thinking about the stories about the great whites coming right through here. Zach was just telling me about coming back from a dive trip not long ago, and he saw a sea lion get up on the rocks and he had been bitten. I thought I was the only great white in this water, but there's some bigger ones cruising. Being down here underneath the ocean and seeing all this amazing beauty, it's calming, it's peaceful. This is truly an awesome, awesome experience. Woo! The Regulator titanium right here. Still working. I had no issues whatsoever. I'm still here, so I guess we're good. This is the American dream. We work hard, we play hard, using great equipment made right here in the great United States, and showing that we can do it right here, keeping jobs in America. Boom.